deserves a knife. I won't let this travesty continue. Face me, Frisco, or this knife will go deeper and deeper until the wound is fatal.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to New Age Horizons. My name is Sean Ed, the voice of the car community. Now, on behalf of NAH, I would like to apologize for the technical difficulties that happened just now. But here is our lineup for tonight: Desmond Cruz versus Adam Hollis. Cannot wait for that. That's going to happen first. But after that, we will have Ryan Amir against a mystery opponent. I love these type of things because you don't ever know what's going to happen here. And it's going to be a big mystery that's going to be solved later tonight. I can't wait. And of course, we have Joshua Phoenix against Barry Stevens here tonight also. What a lineup we have here tonight, folks. Ladies and gentlemen, Adam Hollis, somewhat a member of the Wardens here, of course led by Elijah DeVille, who seems to not be pleased right now after you just saw the message earlier today. Ladies and gentlemen, the music is so bone-chilling right now. I'm sorry, I'm a little bit flustered here, but of course the Wardens are very intimidating, so you can't help but be intimidated by them at any point. Even in your strongest moments, you'll still be intimidated. And of course, Desmond Cruz. How do you guys give me that for forgetting him last week? But, of course, I'm a new guy. Just give me some slack here, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, Desmond Cruz, of course, heavyweight's right-hand man. Carnage with the spear! Oh my god, I feel it in my ribs already. Oh my. Oh my gosh, just knocking down onto the ramp.
You failed me too many times, son. There is no place in this world for you.
Oh my god. The Phil! Out of nowhere, just attacking Hollis right now. I guess their ties are broken. They're no longer binded. They are no longer considered family. They're no longer associated with each other. But no. Come on. This is my workspace here. You can't do this. Come on. No. Oh, come on. No. Oh god! Hollis, Adam Hollis is crashed right in front of me onto the table. Ladies and gentlemen, thank God for speedy rebuilding here from our crew department here. But yeah, the table's rebuilt because, you know, we're good like that. And what an amazing moment we just seen here with so much action in this. Desmond Cruz knocked out by Carnage right here in the middle of the ramp. But then, not too long after that, the Ville crashes Adam Hollis into the table. Thank God we rebuilt it so quickly. Ladies and gentlemen, but of course, you know, this show is not without controversy. Here is a tweet from our New Age champion, I.B. Wright, stating that Aiden, if you want to face the champion of wrestling at VC, you will do the right thing and run the gauntlet for 10 minutes. That is a challenge to Aiden Pericolo. And I wonder if he's going to accept that tonight. I'm anxious to find that out.
See, you're already looking exactly like me. I've got these bruises, these cuts from your beating you gave me last week. I loved it. It showed your aggressive side, the side I always knew was there, the side that I want to bring out of you, Jack. But you see, Jack, that's not enough. See, although you tried to beat me, although you did give me a beating, remember who was laying there, who was out cold. And Jack, if you try to bite the hand that feeds you, you'll be laying out cold more and more. Jack, you felt the tender kisses of my back all over your body. You've got bruises and cuts, just like I do, Jack. And it's all because you won't admit who you are. You won't admit that you're aggressive. You won't admit that the hero himself has his inner demons, that he has his inner evil. Jack, it's why I'm here. Week in, week out, Jack, I'm going to tell these people again and again that the hero is not the hero they think he is. That this hero is his inner demons. This hero is actually evil. Like I said, if you try to bite the hand that is feeding you, the hand that is bringing out your true potential, you won't be leaving with just bruises and cuts. No, you'll be leaving with limbs broken, laying in a pool of your own blood, not being able to speak. You'll be a shadow of your former self, a broken shell of a man. So go ahead, save us, Starran, before I get to you.
Devlin Daneus. I'm a big fan, honestly. You see, Daneus, I studied your matches. I studied your arsenal, I should say. I've seen what you've done with your career, and honestly, you're my idol. You're my hero, actually. I've seen you and Screech in NGC, and I loved everything about you, too. When I heard you two join the Saints of Apostasy, I just lost my mind. I was so happy to see you two back in action, side by side, the return of Rebellion. I've seen everything from you. You're everything I wanted to be as a wrestler, but you just had to show up. You had to ruin my moment, and you have no idea what the sound of a fan's broken heart sounds like, do you? Daneus, you made more rivals in your career than allies, and hell, I like that. You wanted to prove your point in every company, and you wanted to make an impact. But that is not how you make an impact. You show up night after night. You fight any opponent you see, big or small. You fight, and you prove your point. Not with a bat, and not by a sneak attack. That is how you prove a point. That is how I got my foot into this company. That's how I got known. At Viewer's Choice, it'll be you versus me and the fans. The people that watch now will decide the match we will compete in. Because the fans know what to pick. The fans know who to like and who to hate. And win or lose, it'll be a great feeling for me to tear you apart. To tear apart the man that I admired.
Wait, what is he doing? Whoa, oh my god! What did I just see here? Jack Starran just... Oh my... Ladies and gentlemen, thank goodness for that break, because I needed to compose myself. The hero, Jack Starran, jumped off a roof, but I guess he's fine since he's a superhero, but oh my goodness, a match card for Viewer's Choice. Here we go. Devlin Daneus. Jack Starran. The Viewer's Choice for a tables match, submission only, or a no turnbuckle match. Oh my gosh, that's a great match. We also have Mayshard against Ryan Amir in a Viewer's Choice match of Viewer's Choice. Oh my gosh. But of course, speaking of Ryan Amir, here he comes here tonight. Of course, Ryan Amir from Gainesville, Georgia. You already know that. 6 foot, 216 pounds. Former EWF World Champion. Wrestling for 5 years. Love this guy.
One of your owners of New Age Horizons here, Keith Mayshard. And you see, Amir, you hear this? This is what it sounds like to be out of breath. And you know why I'm out of breath? It's because I've been training hard. That's right, I've been training hard, as you've seen. And Amir, while you've been playing around in these matches, I've been getting ready for a match. A Viewer's Choice. Which is gonna be next week. Which will be Keith Mayshard and Brian Amir in one ring. Oh, and Amir, you better be ready. Because I have another challenge for you. Because here's your opponent right now for this week, New Age Horizons. I need a milkshake. Oh, Jesus.
What? That makes no sense. So wait, was that a recording? Keith Mayshard, one of the owners of New Age Horizons, just beat the living crap. He's still beating the living crap of Brian Amir here. Nice little ruse there. Like, I was fooled because I thought he was still training. But I guess training's done now. Oh! Big boot from Keith. I guess he has to work on that cardio. He's out of breath already. Oh my gosh. A message has been sent here, ladies and gentlemen. Brian Amir is showing no quit. Maybe he should quit, though. Oh! Big right hand from Keith.
Here we are, the final stop before New Age Horizons' third pay-per-view Viewer's Choice. Now, it'd be kind of funny if the world champion of New Age Horizons wasn't competing at the third pay-per-view, and we can all thank Keith Mayshard for that. But rest assured, tonight, I'll change that. You guys will have a main event for Viewer's Choice, because that's why I'm here. I'm here to entertain all of you, and I'm here to solve the injustices that have been happening. I have 10 minutes tonight to run a gauntlet to face the person who's been running for 10 episodes, Ivy Wright. Now, Ivy, when I run the gauntlet and when I beat every single person in under 10 minutes, and I become the number one contender again for your New Age Horizons World Heavyweight title, this isn't just for me. This is for the people that you screwed over, people you've driven out of the company, people who you made their life a living hell. And I'm talking about people like Brian Amir. I'm talking about people, more importantly, like Peyton. People that you have absolutely made their lives hell. People that Keith Mayshard has screwed over. And now you guys are even sending Sebastian Case to attack people because you're all one big cult. But here's the newsflash, guys. I'm the antagonist to your cult. I'm the person that will take every single one of you down. You put three people in front of me, you put four people in front of me, you can put 10 people in front of me. I will take them all down. And at the end of the day, at Viewer's Choice, I will pin you 1, 2, 3. Again, you can throw anyone you want at me. At the end of the day, I will be the New Age champion, and none of you can do a damn thing about it. Watch me tonight. You've been warned.
Oh my goodness, it looks like Aiden Pericola has accepted a challenge for Beat the Clock Gauntlet. Yep, it's official. Beat the Clock Gauntlet here tonight. Aiden Pericola has to beat the odds in order to get a chance at Ivy Wright's New Age Championship. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm telling you, tonight is a great, great, great night. Joshua X. Phoenix, Robbie Scott's gym graduate, trained under Alex Strider, one half of Transcendent Wolves. Oh my goodness, this guy. I keep saying oh my goodness a lot, and it's because I'm in awe of all these people here, but of course, Joshua Phoenix, this man here, he is the X. I mean, come on, he is the X factor of New Age Horizons. Stevens here, guys. This man feels that Joshua Phoenix has taken a spotlight from Barry Stevens, and he wants it back. Of course, if Barry Stevens feels that anybody's taking a spotlight, trust and believe, you're in big trouble, because this hot shot, this big galoop, will do anything to keep the spotlight on. Oh my gosh, what a cocky bastard. Just look at him. He is the type of people that you just can't help but punch in the face, you know what I'm saying? I mean, come on, people from Brooklyn, you understand what I'm talking about. This guy here, he just needs a real good sock in the face there. Right in the pot. Just look at him, look at this asshole, come on. And the match is underway. Oh, see? Barry Stevens showing off, and look what's happening. Oh! Crossbody. And a springboard move right there. Already showing who's really deserving of the spotlight. Alright, so you're just gonna run, Barry? That's what you're gonna do? You're just gonna go away. Little punk bitch. Look at him. Can't even handle it. You want the spotlight, you gotta earn it, buddy. Get back in the ring.
Barry, I'm not gonna make you do anything you don't wanna do. At least tonight. Because at Viewer's Choice, Barry, you, yes, you, will face Joshua Phoenix one-on-one. And the three stipulations are... Extreme conditions, false count anywhere, no disqualification. Devel, you've been... The past few months, you've been on a warpath, destroying anything and anyone just to get through. You want to face me so bad, you got it. I just named the three stipulations. Because I'm not here just for any old I'm gonna beat you up match. I'm gonna fight you. I'm gonna eradicate you. I'm gonna eliminate you. And that viewer's choice, I'm gonna do just that.
Wow, choice words from Frisco there. Sick and tired of the god, the old god, just interrupting the show over and over again. Like, I understand it so well. But of course, that's not all. Matches that are announced tonight are just, oh my goodness. Like, I'm sorry, I'm just flustered here today because there's so much excitement, so much electricity. But of course, business is business here. Let's show you what we have coming up at Viewer's Choice. Of course, Deville versus Frisco. The No DQ, Extreme Rules, or FCA match. Viewer's Choice, ladies and gentlemen. Just announced. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, the main event of the evening, Pericolo beat the clock gauntlet match tonight. This is the reason why you tune in. It's for this guy here. I'm a big fan of him, just in case if you haven't noticed. But oh my gosh, a gauntlet match. I don't know if anybody can beat that. Beat the clock in under 10 minutes? I mean, come on, seriously. Like, how could you do it?
We have... unfortunately, though, have to deal with the biggest loser of them all. The biggest loser of them all, Aiden Pericolo. God, he is the biggest loser of them all. Why would anyone think he can come in here and face me? He's nowhere near the level. Never mind the level of ability the loser lacks. It's the lack of moral integrity fiber he lacks. The travesty that he even has a job in this company after trying to run WAW into the ground. Successfully, may I add, actually. Successfully, never mind trying, he succeeded. Why would he be hired to be coming here to New Age Horizons to ruin this plateau of perfection? Send him off to one of the loser companies. Let him kill them. Why? Why would he be hired? Let alone interact with me and my title. He is disgusting. He is a deviant. He parades around young children to introduce him to the ring. The Pericolos, Lord knows what he does to them children. His misogynistic ways and his dirty mind combined is filthy and uncomprehendable. He comes out here gyrating, wearing tight leather, sending all sorts of sick thoughts and vibrations towards children. This is a children's show. There's loads of little loser children watching this on the internet as we speak. This is not right. It is not right. Aiden Pericolo is not the right thing for New Age Horizons. And as much as he may try to blindside me and kick my beautiful teeth down my beautiful mouth into my beautiful stomach, he will not succeed because he lacks character. He lacks integrity. He most of all lacks spine. He is the color of yellow, and if he somehow manages to get the viewer's choice through the obstacles that he must be presented at to even prove to be on my level, if he somehow gets through it, I will disembowel, dissect, and destroy him and viewer's choice for all that is right. I will eradicate this cancer from wrestling. He will never threaten another company, another child's innocent, another eyes of an innocent woman ever again. Most of all, it must be done because it is the right thing to do.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is great to see that his voice has finally matched the size of his testicles, because this man is the scum of the earth to screw over the people's champion here, the dangerous Aiden Pericolo. Ladies and gentlemen, last episode, you saw it. Aiden had Ivy Wright beat fair and square, but then he had to have Desmond Cruz come in and assist him and get him out of harm's way, because he's just a coward. He is just a coward. No matter what kind of crap he wants to spit out of his butt, or why Aiden shouldn't be here, or anything like that, it's nothing but crap. It is absolute crap, because we all saw that Aiden had him beat. Pericolo had him beat. So, whatever is going to happen tonight with this gauntlet match, this Beat the Clock Challenge, it's only going to show the skills that Aiden Pericolo has. That Ivy Wright should be watching this in fear. He should study every single move that this man has in order to prepare. And it still won't even be enough, in my opinion. You don't agree with me, then think what you want. I'm just saying, I'm right and you're wrong. Now let's see who's the first person he's up against in his gauntlet. Ladies and gentlemen, CCD, I don't know too much about him. I don't want you guys typing in the comments saying, oh, you know, he doesn't know anybody. I'm sorry, I'm a new guy. Give me a chance here. I'm pretty sure you didn't know everybody the first time watching or the first time. Sit in my seat, and then you can tell me how to do my job. That's all I got to say. But, yeah, he looks like a very ferocious person. I do not want to meet him in Dark Alley, but let's see if he can impress me in this ring against dangerous Aiden Pericolo. Ten minutes starting now, counting down. Woo! Big clothesline from Aiden. Stomps just taking it out on him. All these hands. He's showing them hands. Oh my goodness. Knocking down CCD. Here comes the pin. He's trying to end it early. Good man. One, two. Oh, kick out of two. Irish whip into the corner. Woo! Oh, those stomps. Oh, those hands. I'm sorry. Uppercut here. CCD has not had the advantage in this match so far. Another Irish whip. Another uppercut. This is signs of deja vu right here. Dropkick. Another dropkick. Alright, so is strength from CCD over here. He is a big man, so he should have incredible strength. Ooh, suplex against the ropes. That had to be painful. Now we can see what CCD is made of over here. Trying to impress me along with this crowd. Looks like Aiden has the upper hand again. He's making a comeback. Double arm DDT. Oh my goodness. I think it's over. One, two, three. And I was correct. Look at that. It's over. With 8 minutes to spare, here comes a second opponent. Bubba Bigums. Big Bubba Bigums. Ladies and gentlemen, I cannot stress enough on how dominating this force is, if only he had taken advantage of certain opportunities laid in front of him. Oh! diving from the outside again. A smart maneuver by Aiden Pericolo. Just keep him guessing what the move is. Do not be predictable. Irish hip into the barricade. Those right hands. There's a break in the count there. He's clearly on the offensive from the idiot Pericolo here. He's got to keep the big man on his toes. Just keep him guessing here. Elbow. Only way to take down the big man is to have him unexpected. To not expect anything, I guess. Oh my gosh. Again, Bobby Bigum's forced to be reckoned with here. Look at that. Already weighing down the People's Champ. Showing the strength and dominance here with all these knees against the rope. There's no escaping that. The only way you escape is if he allows it. Last call. He should pin after this, but he's not, because he's not going to take advantage of situations. That's his downfall. Oh, missed the big boot. As I told you, he should have taken advantage of that and pinned him after that elbow. But again, Bubba Bigums, that's his big downfall. He could be a great champion, a great wrestler, if he just understood situations and take advantage of them. Here goes a throwback. Ooh, right in the clusters. One, two, kick out. Showing Bubba Bigums those legs. Oh, again. Again, keep the big man guessing. Whether it's hands, feet, the entire body, it doesn't matter. Just keep him guessing. Don't have him telegraph your moves. Oh! Oh my gosh, again showing him the legs. He's kicking him. Like he's like Chung Li with those kicks. Oh! Oh, high risk maneuver. This is why they call him Aiden Pericolo, the danger. The dangerous Aiden Pericolo. Oh, diving elbow drop. He should go for pin because he has limited time here. Oh, he's setting him up for something. Oh, hits him right there with the finisher. He should go for the pin right now. Smart man. One, two, three. Bubba Bigums is down, ladies and gentlemen. Still plenty of time if he keeps going at this pace. But who knows what the next opponent is going to bring. Here he comes right now. Ladies and gentlemen, Christopher T. Rosa, the former CTO and RTG wrestler, signed by Frisco himself. Not much is to say about him, but ladies and gentlemen, just looking at him right now, he is, of course, to be reckoned with. Look at him. Look at his physique. Look at the way he takes care of himself. The way he carries himself. 4.5 minutes left on the clock. He needs to take Rosa out. But Rosa looks like he's not going to give up without a fight here. Ooh. Fatigue may be sitting in here for Aiden. Oh my gosh, he just deadlifted Aiden right now. Rosa, oh my goodness. He is muy caliente in the ring right now. Elbow drop. He's going for a pin. He might beat him. One, two, a kick out of two. Oh, drop suplex. Russell's firing up right now. Again, muy caliente. Oh, see, he shouldn't have done that. You can't look. You can't turn your back on danger. His danger will come and bite you in the ass like he's doing right now. Oh, deja vu kicks right there. Ooh. Irish up into the corner. Ah, oh, another one. Oh, sunset flip. Rope break. Oh, that was a beautiful sunset flip too. So fluent. Oh, big right hand. Or is that a left? I can't tell. My direction, my hands are just different. I don't know. Oh, the strength. Rosa. Christopher T. Rosa. Oh my gosh. Frisco knew what he was doing when signing this man. Because this guy's, oh, big uppercut. A-Town stomping on him right now. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Those combinations of punches right there. The strength of Rosa, oh my gosh, this guy is impressing me here. If he's able to do what he's doing to Aiden Pericolo right now, just... I am impressed. He just might beat him and just forget about this beat the clock challenge. Forget about Ivy Wright. Like, if this is the case, then Rosa should be in line for the championship if he beats Aiden Pericolo here tonight. It's amazing that I'm actually saying the possibility of Aiden losing here. But just look at the skills of Christopher Rosa here. Granted, Pericolo did face two other people before him. But I mean, come on. Look at this. He's just toying with him, tossing him into the steps like he's nothing, like he's a doll. Look, he's continuously doing it. Oh my gosh, I am intimidated by this man. It's very scary how he's doing this. Throwing him in the ring, he doesn't want a count out. Very smart, it's a veteran move. Most people tend to block out the referee's counts and don't really hear, but oh my gosh, it's a no one drop here. Here comes the pin, it might end it. One, two, oh, kick out. Danger, the danger is kick out right now. Oh, all right, looks like Aiden has the upper hand here. Oh, he is fired up. He is the danger, he is the one who knocks. Oh, he's asking for the fans to give him support here. Oh, he is sizing him up. Oh, I don't like the looks of this. Rosa, if you were a smart man, you should stay down right now. Oh, 10 seconds left. Oh my gosh. The strength, I don't think he's gonna do it. Oh, sunset flip. One, two, three. Oh my gosh. Wait. Less than 5 seconds to spare, Aiden Pericolo has made it past the gauntlet, the beat the clock gauntlet challenge. Of course, a viewer's choice, Aiden Pericolo versus the New Age champion, I.B. Wright, in a steel cage ladder match or first blood match at viewer's choice. Ladies and gentlemen, it is official. It is written in stone. Wait. Rosa could not take the loss lightly. I guess seeing as he did so well in the match, he felt like he should have won. Well, you know, buddy, get it kicked out. But Jesus, oh, this is not Pericolo's month, because it just seems like he's always getting beaten up after matches here. Oh, again, against those steel steps is not forgiving. It really isn't. And again, show of strength from Rosa with, oh, deadlifting and slamming Pericolo like he's a doll, like he's a pillow or something. You thought Russell was done, but no. Just stay down, Aiden. You don't need this damage coming into your match at pay-per-view. Oh no. I don't like the looks of this. Steel steps are in play, people. Stay down, Aiden. Stay down. This is not the danger that you want. Ah! I am getting a headache just looking at that. Oh my gosh. Christopher T. Rosa, a force to be reckoned with here in New Age Horizons. Oh my goodness. That ferocious beating he just gave Aiden Pericope. And look at here. Look at this smug son of a bitch. I am ashamed to call him the New Age champion, because just look at him. This mother hubbard. This... Ugh! You're getting a lump of coal for Christmas. I'm telling you right now. After the beating you just saw, what happened to Aiden Pericope, you're just going to sit here. Oh, you're going to raise your arms up like you did it. Like you're the one that used your athletic ability to take him down. Like you won last episode. No. No, you are not my champion, sir. You are not my champion. I do not see you as my champion. The people's champion, Aiden Pericolo, is the true champion. You are just a title holder for him. Ladies and gentlemen, later. Viewer's Choice pay-per-view, DeVille versus Frisco. In a no DQ, Extreme Rules, or FCA match at Viewer's Choice. That's not all. You'll get Keith Mayshard versus Ryan Amir. And of course, a Mayshard choice match here. Of course, the news versus Jack Starran. In a tables match, submission only match, or no turnbuckle match at Viewer's Choice. Now, of course, that's not the end of the match card. Of course, we have Sebastian Case, Danny Ball, and Farrell Adolfo, and Mr. Champion himself, the Jackass, in a Heritage title gauntlet match. Oh, I can't wait for that one. Then we have Joshua X Phoenix against Barry Stevens, this asshole, in an Iron Man match, 2 out of 3 falls match, or a hair for hair match. That last one would be my favorite. And of course, Aiden Pericolo versus the champion, I.B. Wright, in either a steel cage, ladder match, or first blood match for the New Age title. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Sean, and the voice of the Caw community. Thank you, and good night.